On top of that, we took a look at the fact that we have a decreased enrollment at the middle school. Most of it is because of the students going to the charter schools, but nevertheless, a very strongly decreased enrollment at the middle school. We need more space at the elementary schools. We have space at the middle schools. And with that in mind, that led us to the first thing that we're going to do, which is move the fifth grade to middle school. And this is going to create the much-needed space that we have at the elementary school. This means we're going to move 4 to 6 classrooms, depending on the elementary school, from the elementary to the middle school. We're not going to move them to the middle school and call fifth graders middle school students, though. We're going to move them to the middle school utilizing a model that we already have been using at Smith. When we started the Ferguson renovation project, we brought 4th and 5th graders from Ferguson over to Smith and created Ferguson and Smith. That is a school-within-school model where the 4th and 5th graders do not interact with the middle school students. We have seen that model work for the past 2 years without issue. And we feel, taking a look at what we need to do to open a school within a school, create an intermediate school, a building just for a school within Smith and a school within Hanover, 4th, 5th, and 6th graders, that we actually can do some different things with them to help improve their academics. And that would bring approximately an additional 250 students from the elementary school into the middle school. The enrollment decline that we were talking about, you can take a look at the slides here, and you can see Smith over the past 8 years, had about an $800 student maximum occupancy. We're down in October 2009 to 421 students. If you see in Hannah Penn, at one point they had 1,000 students in that building. As of October, we have 769. There is room at these buildings to house some of our students. The second recommendation that Mrs. Miller talked very briefly about was the closing of Davis Elementary. We figured out that we can, on an estimated minimum savings by closing Davis, would be $300,000 in reductions in service staff and building operation costs. That's $300,000 that we think we can save. Actually, we know that we can save right now. It doesn't mean it can't be more, but at minimum, we know it's $300,000. We then want to take the Davis students and combine them with the good elementary staff. The Davis students will have to attend good elementary school, but then as part of our realignment, because of Ferguson, we're going to move approximately 200, if not more, students out of the good attendance zone over to the new Ferguson attendance zone. Whether or not we do anything else, that shift of students is going to have to happen. With the new Ferguson, 750 students, we're going to have to move students into that building. The last thing that we would like to do is take a look at creating 11 early learning classrooms. One of the things that we know is that if we can get into the lives of our children into our families at an early age and provide them with a very structured, a very good education in those primary years, our chances of success with those children increase. So we're working on designing an early learning center for kindergarten and pre-K students, and we would like to move all the pre-K and kindergarten students from Davis and Good Elementary over to Roosevelt. The Roosevelt renovation, we know that we need, currently as it sits, we can get a maximum reimbursement of $1.5 million in that building. So we can do renovations and get that money back. We also know that the cost to renovate Roosevelt and add the additional classrooms that we need there is only going to be $3.2 million. The cost of the Roosevelt after the reimbursement is only $1.7 to the district. And if you would go back, when we were talking about Davis, we were talking about over a $5 million cost for Davis.